What's going on, everyone? Welcome to another exciting episode of Forever News! In this episode, boy, do we got some stories to talk about. For starters, we got some awesome news for the Seven Deadly Sins regarding movies. That's right, people. We've got a movie on the way. We got the details. We're going to talk about all of that jazz because, Seven Deadly Sins, I honestly didn't think it would ever get another one. So big news there. We're going to jump into it. We also got two pieces of news for Jujutsu Kaisen. For starters, some major, yet again, accomplishment with the sales, and I love to see it. I don't know. I feel like I've been documenting the rise of Jujutsu Kaisen, and yet again, this is another major monument of it outdoing another series in recent times. But yeah, we're gonna talk about it, and also a little bit of updates on the upcoming Jujutsu Kaisen manga stuff in regards to next arc incoming. We got some pretty huge news for the Bleach anime. Y'all know everybody has been highly anticipating the return of the anime, but we got a little bit of info for the Bleach anime from the creator himself, Taite Kubo. So we got a little bit of insight into the Bleach anime because we're all waiting, fam. We're all waiting. A little bit of news regarding Bo. I always like to talk about that one. Also, we got a little bit of a story, not too much of it, but I did want to mention it, of a series that has been a little bit controversial. I've seen a lot of back and forth regarding it, but I've seen the character design a long time ago, and I was like, she's going to be best gal whenever her anime arrives, and we got a little trailer for it. Don't toy with me, Miss Nagatoro. So yeah, we'll be talking about that. Pretty cool win for Chainsaw Man. I'm just saying, I'm really waiting for that part two, but yeah, we got a little bit of a win there. We got some updates on the Boruto manga regarding the next major threat and a little bit of insight on that, and I'm very, very excited. I know I'm highly invested in a lot of you guys as well in the future of the Boruto manga in particular, and yeah, we got a little bit of insight from the latest issue of V Jump, so we'll be talking about that one. Got an anime update for a certain series that just recently ended, and we got confirmation on another series that we wasn't 100% sure on ending. Yeah, it is ending, so we'll jump into that one. And a cool little update for a Tokyo Ghoul. So yeah, we got a nice amount of stories. Without further ado, let's jump into another exciting episode of Forever News, the only news source that provides anything and everything anime and manga related, and we don't bore you. We get into it. Let's do it. Make your move. That's how it be, though. Okay, people, so for starters, we got a brand new movie coming for the Seven Deadly Sins. I want to say it's potentially either a sequel or just in general a new movie for the Seven Deadly Sins franchise, and I honestly never thought we'd get another one after the last one supposedly bombed, but we got the details. I'm a little skeptical just because, yeah, we know what the last season of the Seven Deadly Sins looked like. I can only imagine what the upcoming season alongside this film is going to look like if they had to split production. So let's read. Seven Deadly Sins anime gets all new original sequel film this summer. Kodansha announced on Wednesday that the Seven Deadly Sins franchise is inspiring a new anime film titled The Seven Deadly Sins Cursed by Light, aka Nanatsu no Taizai Hikari ni Noroareshi Monotachi, that will open in Japan this summer. The film will feature an all new story by original manga author Nakaba Suzuki and will be set after the Seven Deadly Sins Dragon's Judgment anime. So yeah, new Seven Deadly Sins. Honestly, if it's by Nakaba and they actually put like a lot of resources into it and don't half-ass it like what Studio Dean did with the last season. I know everybody says it was outsourced, but the main people that put it together was Studio Dean, and of course, you know, there is the excuse legitimately that they were, you know, on short notice and they were rushed and stuff like that. But yeah, hopefully this film is good, and if Nakaba's in on it, then this could probably be considered canonical to the manga. So we gotta wait and see. Either way, new Seven Deadly Sins movie coming this summer. Next up, two huge pieces of Jujutsu Kaisen news. For starters, the Jujutsu Kaisen manga and the latest Oricon update did something crazy. Because according to this, it says Oricon's top 50 weekly chart by series, Jujutsu Kaisen ranked number one with 1.758 million total sales for the week, and also volume zero ranked number eight with 110,900. So they actually separate those because originally volume zero was not called Jujutsu Kaisen. It was like Metropolitan Police, something along the lines of that. But yeah, if you add them together, that's technically like 1.86 million. So even better. But the big thing about it is that it actually outdid Demon Slayer for the week. Now, granted, you could say, yo, there's no new volumes of Demon Slayer. The hype is dying down. And that's definitely so. But technically now, it by default makes Jujutsu Kaisen kind of numero uno around these parts. Yo, Jujutsu Kaisen doing major things again. Even just doing 1.7 million, Jujutsu Kaisen is in the running for being one of the best-selling manga of 2021. Like, I cannot wait to see what the mid-year sales and the final, you know, wrap-up of the year does. But Jujutsu Kaisen, big things, yo. Now, Demon Slayer is dying down. Jujutsu Kaisen's taking the mantle and it is running full throttle. And while we're on the topic of Jujutsu Kaisen, according to this, it says the Shibuya incident arc of Jujutsu Kaisen will end in the upcoming weekly Shonen Jump issue 9 of 2021, out officially on February 1st. Also in the same issue, a new arc will start. So yeah, finally the Shibuya incident is wrapping up. And I say finally only because it was like a gajillion parts. I want to say it's about like 50 or so chapters that you know, they marked as the Shibuya incident, but it's been a phenomenal arc. Don't get me wrong, probably the best arc of the story thus far, but yeah, it's wrapping up and we're heading into some new territory for the Jujutsu Kaisen manga. And yo, again, big stuff happening for the series this year. Bleach fans, time to rejoice. Everybody that's been excited and waiting ever since we got the official announcement that the Bleach anime will be coming back to wrap up and adapt the final arc, the Thousand Year Blood War. Some questions were asked to Taite Kubo on his recent excursion that he has. I believe it's called like Club Outside, something along the lines of that, where like you get to ask him questions and things like that. And said Club Outside Q&A offered a question inquiring the censorship of the previous anime adaptation, and Taite Kubo's response indicated the upcoming anime will broadcast at midnight and follow the original, ideally no censorship, which is phenomenal, fantastic. I am very, very excited about that. That means it's going to be a lot bloodier and gorier and certain key scenes without any spoilers. Don't worry, I'm not going to say them. Yeah, it's going to be a mess. It's going to be insane, and I can't wait. Like, the fact that they're putting this much time into pre-production and just working on it, Bleach is probably going to look amazing. And the fact that now we know it's not going to be censored, it's going to be at midnight, that means too, if they're looking at a midnight time slot, they're probably getting closer. We could probably see Bleach in 2021. I'm imagining they're probably trying their best to hold off until potentially the global pandemic is officially over, because, you know, con season pushes tremendous amounts of merch and stuff like that, so they probably ideally want to get it out once everything is back to normal. But yeah, no censorship for the Bleach anime, and it'll be at a midnight time slot, which means it's gonna get really dark. It's not gonna hold no punches. Just a little funny tidbit of Bobobo news. A special program to commemorate Bobobo's 20th anniversary will be broadcasted on February 20th on Nico Nico. I have no idea what that's going to be, but shoutouts to Bobobo. I remember, I think it was, on Toonami back in the days, and Bobobo, 20th anniversary. They should do, like, at least, like, an OVA or something to celebrate, but we'll see what the special program, if it, you know, bears anything interesting. And the controversial upcoming anime that will be coming April, if I'm not mistaken, according to the announcement, Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro. If I'm not mistaken, that's the name of the show. A lot of people were saying that there's like a problem with this show and there's a bunch of issues. All I've ever seen for the most part is like the character design. She has a really sick design. I like it. And also I hear it's like a really dope romance. So I wanted to spread my wings a little bit this year and start reporting on this. There's a trailer for it. Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro TV anime gets first animated trailer. Fans of Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro finally get to see the anime version of Nagatoro tormenting senpai in the first animated trailer for the upcoming TV anime adaptation. The Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro TV anime, adapted from the manga of the same name by Nanashi, is set to start its flirtatious premiere in April. So, April season, we stand Nagatoro! Although, again, I'm imagining we're gonna see controversy, just like a certain anime that I keep hearing about. Redo Healer or something like that. I need to check that out and do a video about it, because I'm hearing on both aisles it's insane, it's grotesque. Small update for Chainsaw Man. I want to say it was nominated, and I thought it, like, unofficially, I guess, won. Chainsaw Man was a part of like the Shogakukan Manga Awards, and it actually won a big one for the 66th annual award, which again, I think that it already had been announced, but now it's official. Shout outs to Chainsaw Man. Again, we are all highly anticipating that Chainsaw Man 2. Like, seriously, like, I wish we had it yesterday, but yeah, either way, Chainsaw Man, really major congrats. Like, winning a Shogakukan award is so strange because it's a Shueisha property and, you know, they're competitors, but hey, Win's a win. Boruto fans, we got some very, very interesting stuff going on. So apparently the latest arc of the Boruto manga with chapter 54 is seemingly wrapping up. It seems as though that's going to be the end of the little mini war, I guess you could call it and whatnot. Again, without giving any spoilers, but there will be some spoilers here because we got a little bit of insight on the next threat that we're going to have. This was in, I want to say, the latest issue of V Jump magazine, the same magazine that publishes the manga. Let's read what they had to say. And apparently it's talking about two characters from the Kara group, Amado and Code. Amado's original goal has been fulfilled, i.e. the fall of Ishiki Otsutsuki. Will the refugee Amado live in Konoha as a scientist? Will he cooperate with the scientific team of Konoha as promised by the contract? What's the next move for the Code, who's been monitoring the Ten Tails Jubi? Now that Code and the Ten Tails have lost Ishiki, how will Naruto and Konoha Shinobi deal with this existence that could become a new type of threat? Basically saying that Code is going to be the next threat, him and the Ten Tails. I'm very curious how the hell that's going to work, because Code was kind of like an underling to Ishiki, aka Jigen, and now him and the Ten Tails are left on their own. First of all, the Ten Tails on their own. Let's not get it twisted. The Ten Tails is something very, very scary, hard to deal with. They better be thankful that it's in captivity right now, but messing with a Ten Tails is no joke whatsoever. Then on top of that, we don't know shit really about Code, so if Code is intelligent enough or has the knowledge, he could, you know, suck up the Ten Tails and become a Ten Tails Jinchuriki or some shit like that. So we don't know exactly what's going to go down, but either way, this is seemingly hyping that Code is going to be the next major threat for the Boruto manga. I mean, again, he could very well just be waiting in the wings. Maybe he takes the Ten Tails, because we don't even know what his powers are, and goes to, I don't know, another dimension with the Ten Tails for the time being until like a time skip happens, and then he attacks Konoha or something crazy. But yeah, it's really strange that one of the, well, now I think about it, like Toby was the same way, and then he turned out to be Obito, the main, or one of the main masterminds of the Akatsuki and shit. Maybe Code is the Toby of the whole situation, and him and the Ten Tails are gonna strike when the time's right, and they're gonna resurrect Madara Uchiha. Oh god, no, I ain't gonna lie, I'd be very excited. I don't care what anyone says about it being fan service. If Madara Uchiha, no, I'm gonna say when, because I know Kishimoto loves him some Uchiha. When Madara comes to the Boruto manga, like, I'm 99.9% sure it'll be a great day. But yeah, Code and the Ten Tails, the next threat, and to be honest with you, I still don't trust Amado. Just gotta throw that in there. Next up, we got an update on Hell's Paradise, aka Jigoku Raku. Now, y'all know it was just announced that the manga is ending with the next chapter. However, we got a huge announcement for it. Let's read. Jigoku Raku, aka Hell's Paradise by Yuji Kaku, will be receiving a TV anime adaptation. And what this tells me, right, because this is following suit with what Chainsaw Man just recently did, right? I think because of the success that Demon Slayer has had with it ending and them still continuing with anime and things like that, I want to say that Shonen Jump is starting to try a different model, opposed to having the idea of a manga needs to be ongoing with the anime and stuff like that. They're trying something different with, well, let's end the manga and then adapt it and see what happens, because it worked very well with Demon Slayer. It should work very well with Chainsaw Man, and it seems as though they're trying that approach with Hell's Paradise as well, ending it and then doing, you know, an anime. But who knows, maybe there could be a sequel for it. I have no idea. I only just got the first two volumes, like I said, but Major congrats to everybody that's been a Hell's Paradise fan for a long time. Y'all are getting an anime. I will be watching. I still gotta read my two volumes first, but yeah, I will be watching. I've heard nothing but praise for it, so you may have lost the manga, but you're getting an anime adaptation. Next up, we have confirmation. We just talked about it in the last Forever News episode that Our Blood Oath, one of the latest Shonen Jump titles in the magazine or whatnot, was going to be ending with, I want to say it was the 18th chapter, but we got confirmation. It is 100% ending. It says, Our Blood Oath by Kakazu Kazu has officially ended in Weekly Shonen Jump issue number 8 with chapter 18. Final volume 2 will be out in March 4th. So yeah, another series down the tubes. It's been confirmed. Yeah, you know, every good thing must come to an end. I never got into this one, but I always thought that the art looked pretty cool, the character designs, and it looked different for like a Shonen Jump title. It didn't look like the same standardized look that a Shonen Jump manga has, so it's unfortunate. And lastly, a cool little tidbit of news. Apparently the Tokyo Ghoul manga series by Sui Ishida currently has 47 million copies in circulation worldwide, nearly 50 million, and that is so well deserved, man. Tokyo Ghoul is one of my favorite and arguably one of the greatest manga I've ever read. A seinen that is just through and through, like, wow, tragedy after tragedy. But yeah, I don't know. Either way, I'm very, very happy for it. Major congrats. 47 million worldwide. From the moment I heard Oshi-e-te-yo with the very first season of the anime, the first episode, I knew it was going to be something special. And I'm happy for it. I'm genuinely very happy for Sui Ishida and everybody that was involved with that manga. It deserves it. Tokyo Ghoul was amazing. Okay, people. So bonus story. This might actually become a thing where if a story flies across my desk in the middle of editing and I want to talk about it, I will do so. This is a pretty huge one, though. It's not necessarily anime manga related, but it's one of the greatest American made cartoons of all time. Batman the Animated Series. I see an article that was posted about 2 days ago on comicbook.com, and it's from a reliable source because I've seen the video clip as well from Kevin Smith's podcast. I believe it's called Fat Man Beyond. Don't quote me on that, but Batman the Animated Series sequel reportedly in the works for HBO Max. Following the announcement that Batman the Animated Series has finally shifted from the DC Universe platform and onto HBO Max, it seems like the future of that classic cartoon could be very bright. Speaking on the latest episode of the Fat Man Beyond podcast, co-hosts Mark Bernardine and Kevin Smith brought the rumor to light, with the former firmly labeling it as a rumor. The rumor is that HBO Max is looking at making a Batman the Animated Series sequel, that they want to continue that forward. Bernardine said, as Smith covered what was very clearly a huge smile on his face, "I don't know what you're talking about," Smith said with a twinkle in his eye. "I'm not involved, but I too have heard this, and I've heard this from very reliable people. When I heard it, I freaked out, and I heard this, I would say, a month before you just said it. I think that's real. I don't think that's a rumor. I wouldn't say set your watch to it, but it's an idea whose time is not only coming, I think it came, and it's smoking a cigarette. I think that's gonna happen." How fucking amazing would that be? Because you can just literally pick up and keep going. It's not like, oh, we gotta explain why everyone's older. It's fucking animation, man, so you can go right back to those amazing fucking stories. He continued, "That to me is a no-brainer. You've got HBO Max, you're already doing that amazing Harley Quinn show. You're printing money if you go back and do Batman the Animated Series. You can't fuck up the legacy, that's for damn sure. You can't fuck it up. There's no reason not to do it. As long as you got the key creative components, as long as Bruce Timm is involved, wants to be there, fucking go for it. For heaven's sake." Smith reiterated that once again, he's not involved. He's busy working on Netflix's new He-Man animated series, and as such predicted that a revival of Batman the Animated Series could happen as soon as 2022. No official word about this has been announced by Warner Media, so check back for more details. Yeah, wow. Just quickly, amazing. Like, if they bring, first of all, you absolutely need Bruce Timm. If Bruce Timm is not involved, it is not Batman the Animated Series. It would be amazing. Bring back the whole team. Bring back Bruce Timm, Paul Dini, Eric Radomski, get James Tucker. I don't think he was involved in Batman the Animated Series, but he was later on, like, Superman the Animated Series and everything else. Bring James Tucker in there, Glenn Murakami, get the whole squad, everybody that was involved. Let's go. I really hope that this bears fruit to something amazing. It's gonna be a little bit different just because it's not gonna be as dark, unless they really figure out how to do it, because obviously we're doing digital now. They can't paint the backgrounds on black paper like they did back in the 90s, but oh my god, I hope this happens. I've been on a real big DC binge lately. I just rewatched Batman Beyond from start to finish. I'm rewatching Teen Titans right now. I know Teen Titans isn't a part of the Tim Burton or the DC animated universe of what it originally was, whatever, but yeah, I might rewatch Batman the Animated Series in light of this, getting prepared for 2022. So freaking pumped. Yeah, had to throw the story in there. But I'm curious what you guys think about today's stories. For starters, the Seven Deadly Sins sequel movie. Are you looking forward to it? Are you going to be checking it out? Or after that last season of the anime, you're just done with animated Seven Deadly Sins, period. Your thoughts on the Jujutsu Kaisen news regarding it surpassing Demon Slayer in the latest week of sales. Also, it ending the Shibuya arc in the manga with the next issue. Big stuff. 2021 Jujutsu Kaisen might... this might be Jujutsu Kaisen's year. Thoughts on the Bleach anime going to be uncensored with a midnight screening. Like, this could be the darkest that the Bleach series has ever been as far as the anime goes, because y'all know they were really pushing it to be like mainstream and acceptable for kiddos, even though Bleach was kind of gory too, don't get it twisted, it was a lot of blood. But yeah, they're going full blown, we're gonna see heads fly. Thoughts on Bobobo, what the special program is gonna be to celebrate the 20th anniversary. Are you excited for Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro? I'm calling it, that's going to be waifu of 2021. Everybody's gonna love this character, just saying. Again, major congrats to Chainsaw Man on winning that Shogakukan Award, although I feel like we talked about this like multiple times now, but I guess it's been confirmed that it won the Shogakukan Award. Are you looking forward to the Boruto manga's next big threat? I'm really excited. Like, the Boruto manga has just been a treat for a long time now, and I'm glad that, yeah, we're moving forward. Are you guys looking forward to Hell's Paradise getting an anime? Your thoughts on Our Blood Oath confirmed to be ending? You know, everything gotta end at some given point. It's just a shame when, you know, they end early. Like, 18 chapters is very, very quick. But then again, you know, the creator of My Hero Academia, his previous work, Sensei Nobouge, aka Barrage, ended at 16 chapters, and he came back and look at My Hero Academia, so there's always hope. And Tokyo Ghoul selling nearly 50 million volumes worldwide. That is an amazing feat. And your thoughts on any of the stories we covered in today's episode? But that is all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you liked anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, drop me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram. Hit that bell to get all notifications. And if you want to follow any of my other social media, links are in the description below. I'm from the world. And as always, people, have an awesome day. And remember the golden rule. Anime and manga for life. Bye. Have an awesome day. Peace in. And you guys just watched another episode of Forever News. Have an awesome day. It's nights like this and times like this. What's that? That I can give another hit. But I've got this inside a switch. A natural bliss. But that I made.